Hello everybody, myself is Surjit Akre. I am the first Indian artist who has achieved a postgraduate degree from the Academy of Arts, Repin Institute of Painting, Sculpture and Architecture in St. Petersburg, Russia. I am also the founder president of the Rarik Art Club affiliated to Russian Center of Science and Culture, New Delhi. I have an experience of 40 years as a professional artist. Let us start our own composition. We will start now our painting. Take canvas or whatever surface you want to use. You can use hardboard or paper. First of all, you have to draw the composition on canvas. First of all, draw basic structure. I am using 2B pencil here. Don't put pressure on pencil. Hold the pencil from back. It will put light pressure. In this composition, I have interpreted the feeling of loneliness. In the first plan, I have shown a single lady who is holding an anchor in one hand and by the other hand she is supporting herself. She is in tension, but she don't want to open herself. In the second plan, I have shown two boats and there are couples who are enjoying. The waves are the symbol of her inner feelings. I will show you how to compose the painting to interpret your feeling. For example, you are feeling stressed and sad. You don't know how to say in words. Just sit and think. First thing you have to ask yourself, what am I feel? Are you feeling loneliness or you have any desire or you are remembering someone? Take a piece of paper. Try letting it on paper. Draw whatever in your mind. It is best to transfer your feelings on paper than just sitting and brooding sadness. Simply begin writing or do sketching. Any random words, sensation, sentence or forms that comes to mind, dump it out. After making the sketch, now you can use marker or any sketch pen to make the silhouette. Visual communication is the transmission of the information and ideas using symbols and imagery. It is one of three main types of communication, along with verbal communication, speaking, and non-verbal communication, tone, body language. Visual communication is believed to be the type that people rely on most, and it includes signs, graphic designs, films, typography, and countless other examples. Given how broad a category visual communication is, it is somewhat difficult to trace its history. Nevertheless, there is evidence to suggest that it is the oldest form of communication. I found I could say things with colors and shapes that I couldn't say any other way things I had no words for, says Georgia O'Keeffe. We humans use different tools, sound, words, visual images, movement, ideas and more, to create feelings, thoughts, images and ideas in the audience to communicate the particular message the creator wants to share. The intent is to inform, cajole, move and open the audience mind and perspective to seeing the world in different light than before. That is the role of the artist as philosopher. To draw new perspective on life, to cause others to think and revolve further, and then hopefully to pass on this knowledge to others. Art is solely communication. Without the creator, there is no art, and without someone to review or receive the art, it has no purpose. Just like the famous tree falling in the wood with no one around, if there is no audience to receive the message, there is no communication, and therefore the art is useless without that connection. The audience actually gives art its very life by consuming it and interacting with it. Remembering the audience is as important as the artist, and without that communication, the tree in the wood does not make a sound. Ideas become alive when they are received and communicated. I dream my painting, then paint my dream. Vincent van Gogh. After completing the drawing, it is time now to apply the colors. I will start with dark color. I am applying this color in different part of the composition. In this composition, I will use monotones. Monotone is the color scheme in which you use only one color in different tones by mixing black or white in it. Monochromatic colors are all the colors tint tones and shades of a single hue. This is an example of monochromic color scheme. Monochromatic color schemes are derived from a single base hue and extended using its shades, tones and tints. Tints are achieved by adding white and shade, and tones are achieved by adding a darker color, gray or black. Monochromatic color schemes provide opportunity in art and visual communications design as they allow for a greater range of contrasting tones that can be used to attract attention, create focus and support legibility. As societies become more advanced, travel brought people that spoke different languages into contact with each other. In order to communicate, people developed pictogram around the 4th million BC as a way to communicate. Pictograms are images that represent physical objects and were used to share ideas or ask questions. When people began printing with wood blocks around the year 600, the ability to communicate visually blew wide open. The printed word and the other symbols allowed for ideas and information to be reproduced, shared, and preserved in a non-verbal way. Once these documents were translated into other languages, they were capable of traveling around the world. Semiotics. In an academic context, the study of symbols and visual communication is called semiotics. Broadly, the purpose of semiotics is to analyze how people make meaning out of symbol and how these symbols are interpreted. Now I will use pure blue color in the foreground. To give the perspective, I am using dark shade in the foreground and middle tone in the middle ground. Light colors in the background. For this composition, I will make blue monotone shades. You can see here, I have one figure in the foreground, and in the second plan, I have used two figures in the boat and then another four boats in the deep background. Which convey not only the message of the painting, but also give the dimension of the painting. You can make the different tones by mixing the white and black. Get ready to use, or you can start with pure blue and green. Then mix white and black slowly, make different tones. If you are using acrylic colors, it is better to make step by step color tones, because acrylic colors dry very fast and will be difficult for you to fill the colors very quickly. Keep in mind the focal point of the composition. So you have the focal point, and to come out that point you have to use big contrast in that point. You can use pure black and white near the focal point. I am using black hair in the main figure and pure white light in her face. Take a look at the painting below, in which I express my feelings. Life is so complicated. Sometimes you face such problems that you cannot share with anybody. You feel that you don't have enough words to express these feelings. If you have knowledge of painting, then you can interpret this feeling on canvas and you will feel so light. I have used some symbols to express what I want to say. I have used thorns in her hand and flowers in the background. The thorns are the symbol of problems and unhappiness, which means there is fulfilled life around her, but she has no happiness in her personal life. When you focus on your creativity, it takes your mind off your negative emotions. This light green tone will give very quiet and calm feeling. Art is communication without words. Pu- people tend to communicate with words, both written and verbal. But sometimes conveying idea is done in another way. You have heard the old saying, a picture's worth 1,000 words. Right. That's because art can get ideas across using a different kind of vocabulary. Some people respond more to visual images than words. Scholars and scientists have done many studies on how we learn, and they know that different part of the brain process what the eye sees in many ways. It makes sense that people pursue different means of communication, especially when words are not effective. Art translates idea into symbols. Art also gives the imagination free rein, allowing you to experience the surroundings world in different ways, and then record how you feel about it without relying on words. Think about these quotes from artists who describe how they felt about the creative process. For me, painting is a way to forget life. It is cry in the night, a strangled laugh. Georges Reinhold. I'm applying dark blue at the background figure. The contrast will give more perspective in the picture. In the main figure, I am applying crimson red, which is complementary to blue, and it will give contrast so that our main figure will come. Split this color in other parts of the canvas for balance. Women have always made art. As long as women have been on earth, they have used available materials. to make art. From cave paintings and carved bones status to oil painting, people use art to convey many things, to mark major events. Comment on the passage of time for celebration and mourning, or to adorn personal spaces for satisfaction and a sense of belonging. In a cave in prehistoric Spain, sometime painted animal emerged almost 14,000 years ago. We don't know exactly why this person drew a series of buffalo. But he was expressing something about his life and experience. After filling the whole surface, now you come and see from the distance. From the distance, you can see the whole composition, and if required any dark or light shade, then you can put it. Now you have ready your creativity and you can enjoy series. You will feel that you have exchanged your bad feelings in happy. This will not only give you the happiness, but also will give you the opportunity to make your social connection. You can display your painting in the exhibition and invite your friends, which is one of the most important and enjoyable aspect of making the art. When you will share your experience with others, they will learn from you that the happiness of life. Painting is a universal language of self-expression that transcends time and place. To give the horizontal line of the sky again, I will use some light tone with pure white and smash.